thought you were ready to give up.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, what is going on? Hopefully the mic is doing better today, even if it is a little funky. Hopefully it cruises right into normal status. But guys, hope you guys had a fantastic Easter. It is April 5th. We are rocking out in the house. High five is in full effect right now. Moneymaker craziness starts next week. It's gonna be a good time. Okay, woo, rest in peace, ears. You were scaring me. You were scaring me for a minute, but sounds great. I'm going to take it. You guys are fantastic. I'm your host, Mr. Fat Train here, hanging out, and let's do the damn thing. Let's get right into it with your boy, Long Car, who also has been working on his mic a little bit as well, so thank you very much, Ghost of M. It's not his fault, I assure you. Streamlabs OBS is giving us all sorts of fun problems, so hopefully they'll fix that with a patch sooner than later, but until then, here's your boy, Mr. Long Car. Let's get it on.
Good Monday morning, everybody. Hopefully my microphone is a little bit better than the last time I aired this. Still having some technical difficulties with Streamlabs OBS, the program that I use to deliver you guys the long cars pick. We'll have it crystal clear very, very soon. But for now, these are the best tournaments of the day, today. Monday, April 5th, on America's Card Room. All the goods that you need to know about, let go.
I gotta get out of here. I think I'm gonna lose it.
Uh-oh. Sounds like somebody's got a case of the Mondays.
All right, so I just had to put this into the schedule once again. Late registration has closed for this tournament already, so you can't play it today. But this tournament runs every Monday through Friday, every weekday, on America's Card Room, starting at 10:40 a.m. Eastern Time. It's one of my favorites when I can actually get up this early. $66, 50K, and it does have a 5-hour late registration period in case you wake up a little bit too late. If you're on the West Coast like me to play this one, this is a great tournament. So just keep this one on your radar. In late registration right now, 1 p.m., all of these tournaments, as always, in Eastern time zone start times. 1 p.m., $630 buy-in, $30,000 guaranteed, 8 max lunch high roller with this super deep blind structure, as always. At 1 p.m., it's a 109 30K, 8 max PKO. At 2 p.m., one of my favorites, $55 50K special. At 2:30, it's the 1050 50K. And at 3 p.m., the 215 80K. All of those are running. All of those are open. Late registration right now. Get in it to win it. Coming up today, in fact, this is not correct. 1650 25K is actually... Actually, I stand corrected on being incorrected. This is running today. 1650 25K at 3:30 p.m. At 3:30, it's the $6.60 5K. At 4:30, it's the 4 squared 430. There we go. The 4 squared 430, 440, 4K guaranteed. At 5 o'clock, we got the 630 12K PLO high low progressive knockout 6 max. At 5 p.m., it's the $55 10K. At 5:20, it's the $22 10K one re-entry. At 5:30, we got the 33 30K. At 5:30, it's the $275 $2,500 guaranteed with the mega stack structure. At 6 p.m., it's the 630 30K high roller. At 6 p.m., we've got a 1650 10K. These tournaments are underrated, actually. Like, smaller fields, softer fields, always about $2,000 for first. If you like 1650 buy-ins, these are awesome. At 6:30, we got the 109 25K 8 max progressive knockout. At 6:30, it's the $11 15K special. At 7:20, it's the $215 $25,000 guaranteed 6 max. At 7:30, it's a $55 15K with only a 2-hour late reg. Love these 20,000 starting stack 2-hour late reg structures. At 7:45, it's the 88 40K long car mega stack deep stack structure as always. And the Sunday Brawl flights, Sunday Brawl at the moment is not running. I'm glad I kept that on there because I've been asked a lot about that. They are not running. I don't know if they're not running ever, but they're not running for the moment. At 9 p.m., it's the 215 10K PKO 8 max. At 9:10, it's a 104 50 15K guaranteed hyper turbo. At 10:20, $88 10K. This is a super deep stack. I shouldn't say super deep. It's a good deep stack structure. And at midnight, the $21 10K guaranteed hyper turbo. But wait, that's just the stuff that runs every Monday. Let's go over here now. These are the High Five events that are running today as part of the High Five series. It's running until April 20th, until 4:20. In late registration, right now, started at 2:30 p.m. Eastern Time, 1650, $10,000 guaranteed, 3-hour late reg. Wow, 15-minute blind levels, dude. This is a super deep stack structure. This is awesome, awesome structure here, guys. At 3 p.m., this thing just started, and I said it was a 215 80K. It's actually the 215 100K Vaporizer. 5-hour late reg. Get in it to win it. At 5:30, we got an $11 10K, one re-entry. A maximum of 2 buy-ins on that one. At 6 p.m., we've got an awesome, awesome 2-hour late reg Mega Satellite. $22 will get you at least top 15 are going to win a $445. That's a 420 plus $25 entry into the $1 million guaranteed. That is running in a couple of weeks. In fact, no, that is running the $440 $1 million guaranteed. The 445 $1 million guaranteed is actually running this Sunday, April 11th. 2 p.m. Eastern time. So get your discounted $1 million entry today. At 6 p.m., we've got another... Oh, excuse me. This is the final day. This is the final day running right now. Congrats if you're out there still playing this. Day 3 of the $55 300K PKO. Hell yeah. At 7 p.m., we've got a micro $1.65 buy-in, $3,000 guaranteed, 6 max. This is a pot limit Omaha high-low tournament. And to finish off your Monday night grind, the PKO late toke. I love that. $25, 10K guaranteed with a 1 hour and 52 minute late registration period. So that's a wrap for me. You guys enjoy the rest of the show with Justin Kelly, who's always bringing the goods, always bringing that cowbell energy. Let's go.
I got a fever, and the only prescription is
more cowbell.
Have a great day, everyone. Good luck on the grind. Enjoy the rest of the ACR show. Justin Kelly, take it away.
Thank you very much, my dude, Mr. Lawn Car. You know what's funny? I actually just ordered a More Cowbell shirt. We got plenty of fun shirts on the way, because if you're not having fun, you're doing it wrong. Wow, my boy Lawn Car hitting you with all the 411 you need to know about the High Five series, bruh. And I'm here to tell you, if you do good, this is the list you're going to end up on. Look at this, High Five number 17 kicked off, 420K guaranteed. Is anybody surprised? I don't think so. This particular one's called Light Up. $109 buy-in, ended up squeaking just past that prize pool at 423K. Bulletproof, taking it down for first place for 48 dimes. 48 dimes off $100. Sign me up. Yes, yes, yes. 6969. Wow, that person is like perma ecstasied out or something, but they are definitely looking good for 31 dimes. Honorable mention there for runner-up. Boris RU 1974, I believe, has also made our list several times. Sunday special, 200K guaranteed, also popped off. $215 buy-in. 258K ended up in the prize pool. And Juju Bros, no juju on that guy. $49,000 off 200. Looking good, feeling good. Catch a lot. Clearly caught a lot of cards to find their place up in second for $30,000. I believe Game Theory Optimal we've seen on this list several times. Chip Up or Shut Up, I remember that name. So honorable mentions there. 200K. Guarantee. Yeah, guys in the chat, you'll know when you have to type in something for a giveaway, you junkies. Trust me, I'll tell you when to put the needle in the vein. You don't need to type it unless I tell you. So don't be sheeples. Don't just come on. We're good. We're good here, guys. You got this. 200K guaranteed, popped off at 1050 buy-in for all you high rollers out there. Ended up with 268 runners in the house. I see you guys in the chat. Good times. PD Anjo 7 taking that down for 50 dimes, a little 50x there buy-in. Not a bad day. Baldwin says, I'm actually in that 300k with 30 bigs. Congrats, dude. Deep runs. Bat soup for you, a little bat guano, if you will. $32,000 there. Congratulations. Not today, bro. Also, I remember that name. Guys, I've said it before and I'll say it again. Jackpots are hot right now. This also hit over the weekend. Another $50 jackpot. I think we had one of these $50 ones hit also for $50,000 last Wednesday or Friday. They are hitting all the time. 1000x multiplier. Merry Dancers has something very merry to dance about, because they turned $50 into $37,500. Feels good, man. Sir Flopsalata for $7,500 with one too many money symbols there. My bad. And Gappy 44 cruising on, by the way, in your multi-day tournament forecast. You guys know it. The PKO Easter special, 300K guaranteed. Take that guarantee, put it in the shredder. We added 100 on top there with all the entries. 8,110 entrants when I checked this morning, down to 136 in it to win it. Those are the top chip stacks right there. 1 through 8 with 40 million in chips. And actually, that's a pretty chunky spread from first to eighth there. I mean, even eighth is almost half of the chip leader. So there you go. Good times. All right, so normally it would be Monday, and that means platforms. And I know it's all of your favorite game with extreme sarcasm. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna mix it up today. We're gonna try something new that I haven't had the chance to try with more than about 2 or 3 people. So screw it, we're gonna do it live. Good luck us. It will be the same command, exclamation point join. Just hold on a sec. All right, guys, exclamation point join. Get it in right now. This is going to be the parachute drop game. As you guys can see, there's a target on the bottom. I'm gonna drop all of you at the exact same time, and whoever gets the closest to the target is our winner for $25 free play in the sports book. Exclamation point join. You don't have to worry about switching platforms one and two after that, although I know some of you gambling junkies are really good at flipping coins. We're gonna mix it up, so I'm gonna give you guys about 30 more seconds to type in the word exclamation point join. And then we're just gonna do it, man. We're just gonna do it. We're gonna hang out in the clouds. We're all gonna skydive together. And hopefully none of us splat. I don't even know if that's possible, but whoever gets closest to the middle is gonna be our winner. Let's make it happen, folks. I'm gonna give you about 15 more seconds, guys. Fetchering got tired of 30 minutes of platforms. You know, it's fun, but it's a long game, and it's kind of polarizing. You either love it or you hate it. And then if it's a cat's game, it kind of wears thin quickly. So we're just going to experiment, guys. We're just going to throw shit against the wall and see what happens. Once again, this is for $25 free play in the sports book. And you can break that down however you want. It doesn't have to be all at one shot. It can be 5. It can be 10. Whatever you guys choose. Ian Sheriff says, I like it. I like it. Let's see what's up, guys. We're gonna close it now for exclamation point join. I'm gonna start the drop and we're gonna see what happens. I have no friggin' idea. Worst case scenario, we just spin it in our usual picker and figure it out. But right now, we're gonna start the drop. Good luck. Oh my God, you bounce off each other. Rest in peace. So apparently if there's more, it only highlights the person on the platform who's the closest to the center. So far, Buffalo Soldier. Wow, that was pretty cool. I had no way to test this unless I had like a couple hundred of you, so thank you. I like it. Mother Shucker late to the party, but it looks like it's, unless Mother Shucker finds a miracle landing here. Oh, the sweat. The sweat is real. I was like, what are they slowing down? What is that? All right, we'll take that free play and we'll actually move it a little bit out of the way, but that's gonna be Buffalo Soldier 90, success. Taking it down, Buffalo Soldier 90. We're gonna get you locked in here. Hit me with a whisper with your ACR username and we will get you all dialed in. So Buffalo Soldier 90, you're dialed. Let me go ahead and reset drop, cue drop. Boom, all right, exclamation point join. Get it in, guys, get it in. We're gonna roll with it, exclamation point join. I like it, chat, I like it. It's quick, it's easy, it's fun. Everybody gets their own little avatar. I like it. I think we might've found our new home. This is how we do it, guys. We just test things on the fly. I absolutely love it. Don't worry, we'll still work platforms in here every now and then. I think this was a fun one. It's a little silly too. Farb, you're a little silly. All right, let's go ahead and I want to make sure that our winners are on top of our parachute drop game, which is important. There we go. So we'll take that right over there. All right, guys, you got about, wow, what's going on in the chat? You guys are having way too much fun. Jacko Mako says, I want an ACR hat. So, fun fact, if you guys did not know, ACR does have a merch store now, including the really, really cool Live Lucky ACR hats. I believe you trade in your combat points for them. I'm also working on trying to do some swag merch giveaways on the show as well. So, always working for you guys, for sure. All right, exclamation point join if you haven't done it yet. I believe you all have. And now it is time to start this party. Good luck, GL, as usual, only one win per sesh, so in case Buffalo Soldier is just the GOAT, you're gonna have to wait. All right, let's do it. Start the drop. OMG. That is a lot of cracked out avatars. Good luck. So So I think every time someone hits you, your parachute closes and then reopens. Yeah, okay, so this is really weird. So it shows you how close you were to the center there. Bama Tidwell holding it down at 88.9. Ooh, until give me all that. Oh, God. Azucara at 96%. That's pretty strong, man. I think that's going to hold. I think that is going to hold. That's good, buddy. Azucara, congratulations. Making it happen. Hit me with a whisper with your ACR username, and you, my friend, are going to have $25 free play coming to you at the sportsbook. I'll shoot you instructions on how to do it. But simple game, guys. I love it. I like it. I want some more of it. But right now, I want to get explosive.
Harry, he's alive.
What?
The bomber. He's back.
What a predicament!
And welcome to Bomb Pops, brought to you by America's Card Room. In a moment, we'll choose 8 lucky contestants from the chat. Each person will get dealt 2 cards. We run out an entire hold'em board, 1 card at a time, and whichever one of you ends up with the best hand will be crowned champion. Contestants, come on down. Everybody, please welcome seat 1, the resident donkey. Seat 2, looks like an all-you-can-eat fish buffet to me. Seat 3, actually, no idea. Seat 4, the whale we've all been waiting for. Seat 5. Wait. Seat 6. An absolute crusher. Seat 7. Everyone's favorite ATM at the table. Seat 8. The calling station. Hashtag don't bluff that guy. All right, with everyone seated, let's shuffle up and deal. Speaking of which, this dealer's a little slow. Does anybody know anyone we can hire? Anytime today, dealer, come on. Trying to run a show here, bud. Okay, let's get this party started. Show me the first card. Let's Let's peep that second card. Maestro, finish off that flop. Next up, let's hit that turn card.
And now, the moment you've been waiting for, the River card of Destiny.
Chicken dinner. That's gonna do it for our Bomb Pod, folks. Thank you so much for participating, and congratulations to our winners. If you didn't get to participate in this one, don't worry. Bomb Pods can happen at any time, so stick around the stream, stay classy, and we'll see you at the next Bomb Pod here on America's Card Room. So, you know, I saw the first two cards roll off on the flop with the Jack 10 of diamonds. I'm like, oh, that's so sweaty. And then, like, the deuce of nothingness. And then I see the barber has 10 deuce, and it finds a way to hold the baby. O'Doyle rules indeed, Taz Shane. O'Doyle Brunson making it happen. 10 deuce, the barber 88. It's your first time making it in, and obviously finds the bink. Just like normal poker, right? Your first time playing a tournament, of course you win. That's how the poker gods do it. The Barber 88, $22 ticket coming your way. Hit me with that whisper with your ACR username. Damn, it feels good to be a gangster. Everybody else, pull out them damn lighters and torches, because we burning everything up in here. All right, making it happen. For those of you who haven't seen this segment before, it looks like we're a little bit... Here we go. Okay. So for those of you who haven't seen this segment before, this is a beautiful, beautiful thing where we take the largest cash game hands, we pop them into a replayer, we run it back from one of the player's positions and see what the hell happens. Let's go. We also have some fun new clips for you guys from a movie that I hope most of you have seen, but if you haven't, it's worth a watch. It's called The Grand. It's kind of a poker mockumentary. There's some really, really fun clips in there that we can work in. So let's see how it goes. Fives for us here under the gun. And we're gonna come in for a little standard open, a little over the minsies. Let's make it a buck and a quarter in this 25 fitty game. Islands for days, I do like these stories. I'm here, it took that $55 ticket from Friday and punted it in the Easter PKO for 2 minutes in bounties and no take two. Oh, for two min bounties, gotcha, for two min bounties. Well, hey, at least you got paid on the min bounties, right? And it was a free roll ticket. But either way, man, doesn't sound like you punted. It sounds like you put in some effort if you busted two people. I thought you said you only lasted 2 minutes, because that would be a punt. All right, let's make it happen. The Werby method. This guy knows what's up. God. All right, so fives for us. Under the gun, we open it up here. Folds around, all the way around, back to the big blind, who is going to then re-raise our face up to 500. And we say, sure, I like to party. We got position with fives. Let's just do it. Hey, grind time, baby Doug. What's going on, my man? All right, queen 6-3 peels down. Not the best for us. Yay, we got fives, but we have position. So they're gonna go ahead and fire 338 into a little over 1,000, and we're gonna go ahead and hit them with a call because why not, right? They're gonna c-bet the majority of their range here regardless. They'd c-bet something like ace, jack, ace, king if they missed on this flop. So we're gonna see what they do on the turn. Maybe set it up for a little steal. That makes things a whole hell of a lot easier, guys. We just drill the five ball, and I guarantee you, there is no planet where he puts us on pocket fives here. That's true. All right, so Grips in the house. My dude, good to see you, buddy. So now he's gonna keep on firing 561, and we're just like, be cool, be cool. How do we get the other $7,000 in front of them? And we're gonna start by being real cool and raising it almost 4x, like 3.8x, something like that. And they're gonna go ahead and hit us with a flat. So we just flatted the flop. We raise them on the turn, we get called. Now the pot's at 5,500. They only have about a pot size bet behind. That is not a bad card for us. So then we boat up on the river. Not that we were really ever putting them on deuce 4 or 4-7 for some sort of straight. If they have pocket 6s or pocket queens, then they make a bigger boat and they eat our lunch, which would suck. But right now we're going absolutely nowhere, and hopefully they fire pretty hard into the river. They don't, and that makes sense because we did raise them on the turn. They're only really firing hard on the river if they have a super strong hand generally. But if they have missed diamonds, we're not going to get any value anyways. We got to just go for it. We're going to fire 6,100. We're trying to get the full nut and make it look bluffy. Maybe like we had missed diamonds, potentially. Oh my gosh. I can't with you guys in the chat. You're too funny. All right, so he is going to get it in. Survey says we just win, right? We win all day here. Because if he had sixes or queens, doesn't he just get it back on the turn? Doesn't he just like rip in? We should just win. Just win. Ace queen going down in flames. Where's hop grenade? Somebody summon hop grenade out here. Dude, yeah, let's just win. 17,000 bucks coming our way.
How did that feel?
Felt good.
Yeah.
Yeah, felt real good.
Felt good. Felt real good. Felt really good, guys. All right, cruising around here. Dude, Alex Bleffer in the house. Good to see you. All right, 2550 posted. Ace queen suited here under the gun for us. And we're gonna hit him with a standard little over the Minzy open here, $112. Immediately get three bet by the button behind us here to 412. And small blind leaves, so does big blind. We're out of position, but we got ace queen suited. Now we saw how that worked for our opponent on the last hand. Let's see if we can change that fate here for us. Well, we're gonna make our own fate here as we re-raise now up to 1100 and some change after opening and getting three bet. And they're just gonna hit us with a flat and kneading in the house. What's up, buddy? The barber, if you whispered me, I'm sure it went through. If not, I'll hit you back after the show. I check all the whispers at the end because we're a little busy right now lighting cash on fire. And hopefully not with this ace queen. 2400 in the middle. Looking kind of similar to that last board. Queen rag rag, queen 8-4 out there. We do flop top top. And we're gonna go ahead and keep on firing. The fun don't stop. 675 now into 2400. And they're gonna go ahead and hit us with a flat. So 3750 in the middle. To the turn we go, show me like a queen or an ace. That's not the worst, right? Maybe, question mark. I don't really put a whole lot of fours in his range. He raised pre, then I re-raised him again. Actually, he three bet me pre, then I raised again and he flatted. I don't know, maybe like ace four suited, but I just doubt it. That should be a pretty safe card for us, hopefully, unless he's got like pocket eights. Obviously we're blocking something like pocket queen, so we're not too worried about that. We're gonna go ahead and fire now 1,000, so what, a little under a third pot? 1,000 bucks and about 3,700. Chris Buzz thinks they have jack-jack. Large Farb says I put a few eights in his range. All right, fair enough. No jack on the river. You guys are really convinced he has jacks. Yeah, that would really suck. Hopefully it's a pretty safe river. So 1,000 bucks firing. They're gonna hit us with a call. So 5775, almost 5,800 bucks in the pot. And it's an important pot to both of us, man. Both of us are basically highly pot committed at this point. We only have a pot-sized bet left behind, and they have less than that. That's a relatively safe river, right? We're not worried about that. What does that three change? A whole lot of nothing in any sort of hand range we're putting them on. So, just win? Question mark? We're gonna fire. We're gonna go for it all. And they are gonna hit us with the call. Back out the difference. Good luck us for like a 13K pot? 13.5K pot, show me we're good. Wow, we are not good. We're not good at all. We were never good. Case queen, yeah, bye.
You are the worst card dealer ever. You should burn in hell.
The competition is healthy.
Yeah, wow. All right, well, remember that time I was like, well, don't worry, we're not too worried about queens because we have a queen, so we're blocking that. Just kidding, I'm just kidding. All right, 9-9, deuce for us, making it happen. And with the old Montana banana, double paired, okay, sure, single suited. Under the gun gets out of the way, button here is gonna come in for an open to 143. We have two pairs in a dream, so why the hell not? Yeah, a little bit better than jacks, Chris Buzz, you're right. You're a little bit better than jacks for sure. Shit. I was hoping he had jacks. Damn it. All right, so 143 flatted by us with two pairs, and now big blind getting out of line here. They're going to three bet, click it up to 575, and there it is over here. See, five, our original opener is just going to flat. We're going to flat as well. I was like, if we raised there, we'd be kind of an insane person, but that checks out. Guys, so we flop a set, but you all know where this public service announcement is going. Bottom set in Omaha is a money sucker. It's not going to end well. How can this ever end well? It's a highly coordinated board. There's two hearts out there. Who doesn't have a wrap straight draw in the middle? I hate everything about this. Good luck, us. But I already can just see our cash torching, hence the name of this segment. I mean, I don't see how we don't. We're gonna check, and obviously Big Blind over here is gonna fire pot, 1700. Yeah, Ghost of M, here's the bad beat, every bad beat story ever in Omaha. So I flopped a set, right? You should immediately be like, was it bottom set? We're done here. So pot bet by Big Blind, button gets out of the way, back over to us. We are going to hit him with a flat. So 5100 in the middle. Just show me a board pair. Ironically, just show me a deuce, actually. Like, even a board pair is scary, right? Any other two pair just eats my breakfast, right? My lunch and my dinner, if the board pair is like that. Three diamonds. Any 5-6 combos out there made it. Any ace-5 combos made it. I'm not loving this hand, people. I'm not loving this hand at all. The deuce of pumpkins is definitely what we're looking for, Rocco Daco. So we're gonna go ahead and, oh, God. So I guess we have, I mean, are we betting for value here or are we turning our hand into a bluff? Like legitimately, are we trying to get like a set of threes or fours or sevens to fold and try to rep like we have ace five or five six? Because I feel like we're just turning our hand into a bluff at this point. I don't know, we're gonna find out. They're gonna go ahead and get it all in. Value bluffing for sure, you gotta love it. You're like, I don't know what I'm doing or what the reason behind this bet is, but we're just gonna do it. And wow, what are they working with? Holy crap, really? What? We got called by straight a pair of kings? What? Thank you for the money. Donation, appreciate it. Like, sweet. Thank you.
You're crazy, man. You're crazy. I like you. Were you crazy?
I just don't know, chat. Remember that time I said, like, hey, bottom set sucks, run for the hills? Not if you're getting called by absolute Don Quixotes, man. Holy wow. How are we ever good there? How are we ever... Never mind. Anyways. I'm going to lose some sleep over that one, but that's fine. 2550 posted. We're over here in the Kid Cudi, the cutoff, with King 10, 8, 6 with some spades. Couple folds in early position. We are going to come in for a raise. Let's make it 175. And the button. Hey, Action Dog, appreciate it, man. I spent a lot of time hunting down movie clips for you guys. Fun and unique ones, and we're building up quite the library of fun stuff. So our first world problems are going to be which one to play on the show here in the near future. Small blind is going to hit us with a flat. Big blind does as well. So 5 1/4 in the pot to the flop we go. That's a whole lot of kings, and I like it. Question mark? I'd like it better if we could find a friend like a 6, 8, or 10 possibly. But king, king, queen flops, possible clubs, other possible boats out there. Queen's full, king, queen, obviously, but not a bad start. John Paul the Great, I'm glad you like that, man. I just kind of flew with that one off the cuff, a little Don Quixote. All right, so now 5 1/4, they're just going to just slam a pot bet right off the bat here, which on that board texture is interesting. To say the least, we are blocking the old royal flush there with our 10 of clubs, if that really matters, if we were worried about that. Big blind here gets out of the way, and we are going to hit him with just a flat. 1500 in the pot to the turn we go. I'd like a 10, an 8, or a 6, please. Thank you. Assuming they don't have king, queen. Thank you. Okay. So that's a great card for us. We are, what, second nutted, right? I mean, if they have king, queen, that's great. Otherwise, we get all the bacon. They are not slowing down. They fired out a pot-sized bet on this flop with this board texture. Now they're firing out another pot-sized bet on the turn. We're gonna go ahead and just hit them with the flat because pretty much we're going nowhere on the river. I would say we want a card lower than 6, preferably here on the river. An ace, a jack would be both kind of shitty for us. A 10 wouldn't be too bad, but let's see where this goes. And here it is. 7 of clubs on the river, hoping, I guess, that they made a boat. And don't show up with king seven. King seven would be disgusting. Don't even think about doing that to me. 4,700 in the pot. they are gonna fire 4,700. They're gonna pot it again. Doesn't really matter. We only have 2,400, so let's get it in. Let's back out the couple grand difference. This is gonna be for like 9K and some change. Show me that we are good. Oh my God, dude. Oh, he rivered that effing seven. Now let me tell you something about that river.
Let me tell you how the internet screwed up poker, okay? When a guy sucks out on the river, on the internet, you cannot take the guy out in the parking lot and you cannot break his fucking knees.
God, so brutal. So brutal. Nice hand, nice seven. I'm just gonna step outside and go puke for a minute, if you guys don't mind. It's not a big deal. I didn't need that money anyways. Let's go visit the horses.
What time is it? Derby debauchery! Ha!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Derby Debauchery! It's a beautiful day here at the America's Car Room Track, and the races are in it to win it. We have horses from all around the globe, some of which are clearly not even horses. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Derby Debauchery! It's a beautiful day here at the America's Car Room Track, and the races are in it to win it. We have horses from all around the globe, some of which are clearly not even horses. Without further ado, let's get this race underway.
There you have it, folks. Horse number one has spoken, although he definitely runs like a normal human being and nothing like a horse. But make sure you go ahead and type Derby right now in the chat if you haven't done it already. No worries indeed. Let's make it happen, guys. Free tickets are free tickets indeed, Favre. You know what's up. 660 ticket coming your way. And we are going to choose the winner right freaking now. So I noticed that, what kind of shroomy developers are dreaming that up? I have one news for you. Japan. One news for you. One word. Japan. Japan World Cup. This is the DVD. This is one of them. There's three different volumes. I have like 40-something different unique races. And we divvy them up and see what happens. So that was a 660 ticket. Without further ado, let's get it on. I'm not greedy. Give me that baby ticket, says Chris Buzz. Hey, if anything, if you get a smaller ticket than you really wanted, don't worry about it. Find your tournament, run it up. Run it up into FatCast. Nobody's stopping you from turning that $6 into like 600. And it looks like, ooh, almost to Samwise, but not quite. Zapod, LOL. Zapod, LOL, making it happen. Hit me with a whisper with your ACR username. I will get that ticket credited to you shortly. Obviously, the barber already won the bomb pot. We had two winners in the sports book earlier for Buffalo Soldier 90 and Azucara. But right now, we have stuff to do and see what these guys are doing in the sewer. Alrighty, guys, welcome to a segment I like to call You Dirty Rat. Same thing as Torching Cash, however, this is a beautiful D-Gen place of awesomeness. If you don't know how to get here, I can show you real quick. It's very simple. All you gotta do is open up the America's Card Room client, cruise over to the cash game section in either Hold'em or Omaha, and then here's what you guys can find. Check this out. Let's click on Hold'em, no limit, all, and then I like to sort by table name here. And then you can find all of them up here with the 7-day no rattle. Since they start with a number, they will be at the top. Take a peek. Looks like nobody's sitting at any of these tables right now. Oh, here we go. Yeah, here we go. We got one right here. He's sitting at the 2550. Again, when you can only come in with 10 bigs. So he's sitting there. You start with 500. He's sitting there with 6K. Any other big stakes here? Let's see. The 1530, right? You only start with 300. He's sitting there with 2800. So all sorts of options to be had there. And let's take a look at the largest ones that went down over this past weekend. 75, 150, meaning they can only start with 1,500. We've already got heads up players who've worked it up to 23,000 and 70 dimes off 1,500. I wish. That would just turn into probably a new sports car or something, you know what I mean? All right, let's make it happen. Ace King off for us in the big blind heads up. More than enough to get in trouble. Let's just win, let's just find a double. They're gonna start by popping it up. They're gonna make it 375 to go. Chris Buzz, what's up? Dude, I like the Waluigi emote too. Now we are going to re-raise their face up to just shy of 1500 now at 1470. And they are then going to re-raise us to 3800. Do we just slam it in and try to take him to the Church of AK? Is that what we do here? I think we do. We're gonna get it in for 23 grand. They're going to oblige. I mean, I don't wanna pre-celebrate, but just don't show me aces or kings. Don't show me aces or kings, and we can work with that. Okay, queens, the old, I mean, this is a timeless matchup. Ace, king versus queens. Let's go. I don't even care that I'm not suited. I could draw to two different flush draws. Ah ha ha. I do. I am glad that we cover the diamond though. That is nice with the ace of queens. Oh God. Well, they flop top set. And we are in a whole lot of trouble. So regardless of what happens here from this point on, we need runner. We're gonna need a running 10 jack. We're gonna need a running diamond. The old $47,000 pot with ace king, ghost, you know what I'm talking about. Six on the turn is gonna put us dead like a duck, and I am just kidding. Yeah, nice hand.
It's apparent that you have no concept of pot odds. There are a number of books available in the gift shop that explain it quite thoroughly. Also, you have corn in your teeth.
Yeah, that is just gonna be a quick way to rip out my entire pocketbook in the rat hole, as well as most of my soul. So that's how that one goes. All right, so 200, 400 posted, a little bit larger limit than what we just looked at. So you can come into this table with $4,000. So you can see somebody like seat one just started and they hit us with the double up. Now you cruise, I love it. I know everybody wants to know what movie is that. I knew it. I knew you guys would all, nobody's seen this movie. It's called The Grand. Google it. I think it's from 2012. I think it's a big mockumentary about this poker tournament. Party Poker is like involved pretty heavily with it, I think. I don't know if they sponsored it or whatever, but it's funny, man. And there are so many actors and poker pros that you know in there that you'll recognize. Knock yourself out. Have fun. All right, so check it. King Jack for us here in the big blind. 200, 400. We're sitting on 21 dimes. We got our Huckleberry down there in seat five with 70K. And of course, seat one with about 8K. Yeah, Nutzer says, I've owned it since the Blockbuster days. Yeah, one of like the donkeys, who you'll definitely recognize as an actor, gets involved in a three-way all-in pot with him and Helmuth and Brunson. And of course, Brunson and Helmuth both have sets, and he's got not a set. I'll let you guys know spoilers, right? It's just one quick scene in the movie, but I went through there, watched it the other night with my boys, and was just specifically sitting here writing down time codes for great clips we could cherry pick for you guys. That's what I do, man. That's what I do. All right, so Button here is going to come in for a min raise open. Small blind gets out of the way. We are going to oblige with a flat because we're out of position. Good old King Jack offsuit. Sticky seat, this is not a poker client. This is actually a poker hand replayer tool brought to you from the website Pokeit. P-O-K-E-I-T.co. Pokeit poker. King Jack for us here. We are going to flop top pair with not the worst kicker. First to act. Now, again, we are against our aggressor out of position here, so it makes sense to check this all day. Nice. It's on Amazon Prime. Going to watch it after work after marbles. Nice. Going to watch it at work after marbles. Even better. Get paid to watch some poker. So they are going to fire now half pot bet 900 into 1800. Everybody in chat is now firing up the trailer for the grand. I know. All right. That's funny. I knew a lot of you guys wouldn't have seen it, so I'm glad we could share it with you and bring fun stuff, man. All right, so we are going to make it 2,700 to go now. We do hit him with a check raise. They're going to hit us with a call. So 7,200 in the pot to the turn we go. That's a pretty sweet turn. I have zero problems with that turn. Also, I would have zero problems if the king peeled on the turn since we have the king of hearts. But either way, going absolutely nowhere. If we're up against like a set, that could suck, but whatever. All right, so this time we hit him with a check raise on the flop. Now we check. Interesting spot. Are we gonna try to hit him with the old double check raise? And they fire. They're gonna fire 1800. They're obliging. They're in. And now we are gonna hit him with the flat. Fun line that we've taken. We check raise flop with top pair. We turn trips. Then we just check call after they bet again. All right, let's get weird. To the river we go. Don't show me a heart. That'll work. That should be relatively safe. Unless our opponent has some weird hand like queens. I mean, they only really min raise pre-flop. I mean, it doesn't mean they can't have queens. We didn't really push back at them. Sevens would suck. Fives would suck. I mean, right now, we're just looking to find the win. So we check raise flop. We check call turn. Still holding our same trips with a strong kicker on the river here. We check the river to our opponent. 10K in the middle, like you said, Ghost. Only 17K behind. They're going to get it all in. I mean, this looks like a big bloated number. They fire 63,000, but they know we only have 17K. So it looks like we are going to hit them with the call. Let's back out the difference. This is going to be for about a $45,000 pot. 9-10 is no good. 10 high is no good. 10 high is no good. 10 high is no good. And then I looked at the guy and I'm just like, you want to go again?
Am I finished? I've just begun. Am I finished? No way, big boy.
All right, we are going to take it, baby. Let's go. Two hands left here. Then we're going to shoot some marbles for some tickets and call it a day here. Get you guys on that Monday grind. 200, 400 posted. And woo, look at that hand to start out, baby. Ace, king, king, jack, single suited heads up in a 200, 400. Let's go. But let's take a moment to look at these stacks. 200, 400 means you start with $4,000. Run it up. Good for you. Now, we have 10x that. We took that $4,000 to 40, which is really cool. We all know where I'm going with this. Look at seat one. $813,000. The moment is growing very close where we will see someone on one of our segments in the rat hole with $1 million in front of them. You gotta love to see it. Wow. Just be like, you know what? I mean, what's that feeling when you say, you know, just cash me out. I'm gonna go buy a mansion. Just cash me out. I'm gonna go buy a mansion. Not McDonald's, a McMansion. Okay, good talk. See you out there. And I'm talking, and don't get into housing real estate prices. I'm not talking about a mansion in Malibu in California, right? I'm talking about a mansion probably in the sticks, but it's a mansion nonetheless. All right, so they're gonna make it 1,200 to go. We are definitely gonna raise that up. We're gonna make it 3,600. Million in front means cash out as quickly as you can, run. Once you gain that extra comma, ooh, life feels good. Just ask Vanessa Kate about it. She's still floating and grinding and figuring out what sort of several thousand dollars she wants to spend on a laptop. Like, it doesn't even like move the needle. It doesn't even scratch the surface. It's nice. All right, so check it. 3,600 now called. 7,200 in the middle. And we're just going to flop a jack high board. Jack 3-3, super rainbow. We got some backdoor spade potential. Right now, we have ace jack as well for fun. But our kings are still looking pretty healthy. So kings and threes. Kings up. Cash me outside. Hey, people, I could see you guys running through the movie. You're like, Woody Harrelson stars in this movie? Dude, everyone is in that movie. And it's celebrities who I genuinely know are into poker. A lot of those people played in, if you guys were privy last year when we did our celebrity charity poker tournaments, we did one with Ben Affleck and his crew for Feeding America. We did a follow-up one with Discovery Inc. all about benefiting Mount Sinai because they were on the front lines of the whole COVID thing. in New York. And all of those people, Cheryl Hines, everybody who's in that movie pretty much came in to hang out with us. So good times. 1800, we fire, they raise. They hit us with that ooh la la raise to 8200. Everybody wondering how you guys missed that movie. I know, man. I know. A lot of people missed that movie. I remember seeing that movie and then put it out of my head for years. And I was like, oh, this is amazing. All right, so 8200 called, eight of hearts on the turn. Right now, we're still just working with our kings. Hopefully, we're not up against something like aces or perhaps a three. That would really suck. Good luck us. Shannon Elizabeth. Shannon Elizabeth is only in there for like one small cameo scene of like 15 seconds, which kind of surprises me because she was all over the show, like Celebrity Poker Showdown, along with her and Kevin Pollak back in the day. So I know she's definitely in the cards. She's been in the cards for a while. And yeah. All right, so 13,000 now after we check bet. So pretty chunky, almost half pot bet now by our opponent into almost 24,000. And we're just gonna get it in. We're just gonna get it in, guys. We say, let's put in all the monies here for our kings are no good, so be it. And they are going to call. Good luck. And we are up against a three. You hate to see it. We are drawn real slim here, only 10%. And that is not gonna do it. That is not gonna do it. I mean, here is basically the way I like to approach this situation.
If people played correctly, I would win every single hand ever.
Not straight.
Mother! People misplay. And then they end up with what I like to call good fortune.
Good fortune. You know what I mean? Good fortune, guys. Good fortune. Absolutely love that I can share these clips with you guys. You guys got to come back and tell me how many of you guys went and watched this movie. It's just too good. It's just too good. I mean, it's super campy. You're not expecting anything amazing. There's definitely some lull moments in it, but it's just fun because you're like watching everybody that you kind of know, right? All right, so Jack, Queen 10, couple of diamonds out there, and David Cross. What a legend. Oh my God, that guy. Just gonna have some cocktails with that guy, man. That's a good time. All right, so $431 is what we're gonna make it. Button fold, small blind comes along. Big blind wants to party as well. Just shy of 1300 in the middle. Let's get it out. And top set. Now, top set and open-ended. Now we can start talking about how much I like sets in Omaha. Bottom set, not so much. Top set, good. He's a never nude. You guys know. Come on, Arrested Development. Fantastic. Remember when he painted himself all blue? You guys know. We all know where that joke's going real quick. But here it is. Our opponent gonna fire a 650, and it's about a half pot bet, actually. They're into 1300. Seat one finds the fold. We are going absolutely nowhere. Mr. Show is a great one as well. Yeah, him and Bob Odenkirk. Obviously, Mr. Better Call Saul. Amazing, legend. He actually has a new movie out right now that I'm looking forward to seeing. I forget what it's called. It's called Nobody or something. Easily forgettable title, clearly. So they fire, we call, 2,600 in the middle. To the turn we go. That's a deuce of nothingness now. We're looking at top set, still healthy. And also the absolute nuts, not a bad spot to be. They keep firing, now they pot it this time. They half potted it before, now they full pot it. 2,600 into 2,600. And we are going to raise it up. We say, now is the time. If you wanna call me on your draw, so be it. We're gonna make it 10.3K to go. They're gonna hit us with a flat. Weird spot, 23,000 and some change in the pot. Very important pot to both of us. We have almost 20, they have 12K behind. To the river we go. Show me like a random non-club like ace or king or something. I mean, or that, that'll work. We'll take that. So we end up making the stone cold nuts again in a different way, but we'll take it. So queen 10 now, our top set turned in, top set nut turned in a top straight nut. And this is not a bad spot to be. So 23K and some change. They just rip it in and we're like, please tell me I don't chop. Just tell me I don't chop. That's all I wanna know. We're gonna get it in as well. Show me the monster. We're way good. Wow, pair of nines? Yeah, it's tough to rep queen 10 when we have queen 10. So yeah, wow. All right, I mean,
fantastic! We win!
I won!
Easy game, folks. Easy game. Get your marbles ready. Polish them up, because we rolling.
Prestige. Honor. Glory. Now is
your time for greatness.
Let's get ready to marble! All right, guys, hold your marbles. We gotta get in the game before you type exclamation point play, but it is a very simple concept. That's all you have to do. However, you do have to be on the Twitch side of things. I like that. Good spot to bluff, but alas, no good. No good indeed. All right, now you can go ahead and get exclamation point play typed in. Thank you very much, Ghost. Always on it, in it to win it. And as usual, you guys have to be on the Twitch side of things, so we appreciate you if you guys are hanging out, watching on Twitter, Facebook, or YouTube, but you gotta cruise over to twitch.tv/America's Card Room. If that forward slash throws you off because you don't know which is which, just type in americascardroom.tv. It'll get you right here. And then all you gotta do is type in exclamation point play. The directions are beneath me in case you can't hear me or you just don't care. But there they are right there. Exclamation point play. Get yourself a marble. First marble to cross the finish line gets a 1650 ticket. And as usual, Ricky Bobby is activated, meaning we give away an extra ticket on the fourth race as soon as we hit 200 marblers, which you guys pretty much always do these days. And we're gonna activate him, it looks like, right about now. There it is.
I'm just a big, hairy American winning machine. If you ain't first, you're last. You know what I'm talking about? That phrase, trademark, not to use that position, Ricky Bobby Inc.
Copyright, Ricky Bobby Inc. All right, guys, get it in there. Ghostus with the mostus, you gotta love it. Let me give you guys about 10 more seconds to type exclamation point play. This will also give you guys a quick opportunity, if you haven't done so yet, smash that click, heart, follow, subscribe button. We are here with you every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, kicking off at noon Pacific with all sorts of fun interactive chat games, giveaways, news announcements, you name it. I try to get it here first to you guys. That's it, man. We're just about making money and making opportunities here. Let's get it on, chat. I'm gonna type in my exclamation point play. By the way, you can do play and then a number. I'm gonna go play 6 for the happy frog ball. And let's kick it off. Now we do kick it off, of course, with our inaugural Marbles Jam by It's Payday. So let's get it on.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the Chica ACR show. I wish I could have that not volume peak so bad for you at the beginning, but you love it. Yeah, it's like these marbles got me losing my own. Who's on the phone? Fat train, hit me up on the phone. He's like, you wanna do a track? All right, this is a typical racetrack, guys. You gotta do 3 laps. The yellow number above your head is the lap that you are on. Holding me down till I'm deep in the hole in the ground. Scolding the crowd as a fire out a couple of rounds. A grenade and train, raising up dollars and pounds. We got a long car going over past the abyss. Hit your beats, no surprise that most of them are his. Now this ACR chat is where the legends are made. A step up in game, venomous rain. Mad Dog leading it. Yeah, the volume peak is just to wake you guys up. Let you know it's time for marbles, baby. It's time to settle your fuse. Boom, definitely not one lap, guys. We are gonna be doing, it looks like 3 laps. You can see right next to the number of marblers on the top of your screen, 3 laps. Let's make it happen. Everybody's on lap 2. I don't know if I've ever seen a marble get lapped on that. I mean, it's kinda tough. If you get lapped on this course, like, you're pretty slow. You're pretty slow. Why am I not winning yet? Yo, Train, I challenge thee to a pinball match on 8-Ball Deluxe for Rolls. Pappy Van Winkle. Let's make it happen, guys. As far as travel plans, once this whole COVID thing starts to subside a little more, they've already announced the WSOP. I know that me and the ACR crew, most of us, will end up being out in Vegas for a lot of that, at least shuffling back and forth for myself because I'm not too far from there. But I plan on going out, hosting the ACR show there live. Maybe we'll get a little cameos from some of the ACR pros on the grind, but it'll be fun. It'll be a blast. As far as traveling, so maybe catch me out there. I know Longcard talked about doing a home game in Tahoe. Catch me there. We'll find it, bro. We'll play heads up for rolls. Who is your daddy and what does he do? Poker George, what's up? Good to see you. By the way, thank you for the follows. X Nightmare, DZ Drunk, Modal Flux, Talina Swag, Poker Mad. Appreciate you guys. Everybody else who hasn't done so yet, smash that follow button. We are all about good times and good vibes. And it looks like we might be crowning a winner right here. Who wants to go watch Beetlejuice Tallyman Bonanza? Let's go. Tallyman 14, making it happen, buddy. Congrats. Hit me with a whisper with your ACR username here on Twitch, and I will get you dialed in, my friend. That is it. That's all you got to do. You just got to hold on to your butts and win. Ricky Bobby unlocked. Boom. All right, that is one race down, three to go. You guys know what to do. Exclamation point play. Put it in there. Let's go. I like that. Ryan Lacey knows what's up. He's like, I've seen NASCAR. Turn left. Turn left. Keep turning left. More left. All right. Exclamation point play. Let's make it happen. Whoever asked if you were late because you were late for marbles, you were late because we started over an hour ago. You got to be here from the beginning. It's not just the marbles hype. You got to be here for that derby debauchery, the bomb pots. Those can happen at any time. Of course, you got to get your lawn car segment update. Then you got to play some games with us. See, you didn't even know the game we played earlier. We all went parachuting together. Where were you at? Not here, man. Not here. Exclamation point play. Get it in. Boom. You don't even know the grand height. I love it. Yes, and if you do see people with weird marble outfits, that is because they purchased them using the Marbles on Stream app. I promise you it doesn't give them any sort of aerodynamic edge, but they do look cool as hell. So I definitely encourage that as well. Nice. Let's go, chat. Final 5 seconds to get it in. Even Nightbot got in play. How did Nightbot get in play? If Nightbot wins, this is rigged. Let's go. $256 marblers in it to win it. Let's go, chat. There's something strangely familiar about that car. Whoa, where are we going? Four people eating my marble exhaust. Do marbles exhaust? Ooh, how about a Days of Thunder movie clip for marbles? I like it, Cyrus. Why don't you find a good one for me on YouTube and shoot it to me? I'm down for a little Days of Thunder. We can add a few clips for the marble swag. If Nightbot wins, I get a ticket. We'll take it. Wow, lots of marble death. Right now, I need you guys to go the distance with some cake. The green light flashes, the flags go up, churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank, fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Strong chance Nightbot just died with the rest of us. Actually, Nightbot was doing fine, but half of you guys made a little marble prison shiv and took him out. It's just rude. Extremely rude. SPB, my one love. One love hype, congratulations. SPB, my one love, making it happen. 1650 ticket coming your way. Hit me with that whisper. And right now, enjoy the distance. Slot DJ's like, wait, I got a record? At one point, you were our fastest marbler on this, yes. Not this race, though. That is your ghost marble from before. Now, when that was, couldn't tell you. I'm pretty sure they reset every season, but...
Truck force in his mind, he's still bright.
Crooked Creek, I read your message. Shoot me a whisper explaining exactly the situation and I'll forward it to them. I've had them fix a weird issue similar for me in the blackjack tournament in the past where I was on the last hand, and the very last hand, if I split, it would just break it. And they fixed that. So shoot me a more in-depth description of that. All right, everybody else, that is two down, two to go. Let's make it happen. Exclamation point play. I'm going to go play seven. I got to go Tiger King on this one. Carol Baskin. Get in those plays, folks. Ooh, this is a quick one. This is a crazy one. If this is the one I'm thinking of, it's just a super speed run sprint to the very end. And if you hit an obstacle, you're pretty much launching into space. So good luck. Good luck, everyone. Good luck. This is a shit show. It's a bit of a blur, but when it's over, we will crown a champion. World record on this one, 58 seconds. Our personal best record on this from Bride of Chucky at a lot more than that, at a minute 33. So apparently we're a little slow on this course. Good luck. Good luck, chat. I like that. Somebody came in here named Brutality. Marbles wins. All right, final 5 seconds, guys. Then we're going to kick it off. Ooh, right now, a little Planet Rock swordfish action. Let's go. Here's the all call right here. Did I have a good weekend? I always have a good weekend. Every weekend I end up surviving is a good weekend, my friend. Except for that one weekend in Vegas. That hurt the pocketbook. No, I'm just kidding. We're good. I'm not kidding. All right, let's make it happen, guys. This is race number 3. This is another standard race. The next race after this will be our Ricky Bobby race. The one where you died. No. Luckily, we didn't die. We died for a minute. We came back. Yeah, perfect. All right, yeah, I like that. All right, so Crooked Creek, Mother Shucker, you guys can send me your descriptions. But I will shoot that over to them and have them test that and get that fixed. Yeah, we are flying. Toe Typer in the lead right now. Oh, wow. Rogman, you got to hold the baby here. Nobody get popped. Wow, Iceman, Toe Typer, battling. You had a good weekend. It's up 36 hours. Yeah, that sounds like you didn't even have a weekend. Sounds like you had a coma. Where are we going? Where are we going? We are losing a lot of marbles there. GG's all the marbles that we lost. The Bob Father looking pretty chunky here. World record was at 58 seconds. We're not going to hit that, but we might get a new personal track record here for us in the stream, possibly. Unless somebody else beats you and sticks the landing. The Bob Father looking really good for a 1650 ticket here. Easy money. Plus a new ACR show record. Very cool. The Bob Father. You know what to do, buddy. Hit me with a whisper here with your ACR username and we will get you dialed. 1650 ticket coming your way. All right, so who's holding up the whole thing here? Nutser, what are you doing? Were you just taking a smoke break at the beginning? I mean, I know it's the high five series. Your courtesy break's coming up pretty soon. I mean, I get it. Nutser. It's so funny when somebody's playing the high five series and they have no idea, like they're not in on the joke. They don't get it. They're like, wait, a courtesy break? What is this? Like why, bruh. Go find some tree, smoke a bowl, knock yourself out. Enjoy. That's why it's 10 minutes instead of 5, people, because we know you stoners are going to take twice the time you should. All right. Oh, no. Nuts. You got all the way there. Oh, you got all the way to the end and then just got booted. That's rude. Rude. Just rude. All right. Last race right now. Let's go. All right, exclamation point play, get it in, guys. As usual, this is the ACR show. I'm your host, Justin Kelly, aka Fat Train. you guys are the chat, exclamation point play on twitch.tv/America's Card Room. If you haven't smashed that follow button yet, what are you doing with your life? I promise you, we're here to make the start of your work week fun, the hump day acceptable, and Friday going into the weekend, we just kick it off with all sorts of fun, including extra giveaways like lawn car home game tickets, because it's the D-Gen friendly home game of Destiny with unlimited rebuys for the first hour. That's going down on Friday. Last Friday, we had a good time as well. I don't remember if I made the money. I think I made the money. I don't know. I blacked out. It gets weird in the lawn car home game. Shots every hour, you know. In my case, shots every like 10 minutes. Same, same. You need to brew. Unfortunately, you are not alone in that, buddy, but there is nothing we can do. You just gotta make it happen. All right. You barely made money. Oh, that's right. Damn, that's sweet. That's right. I think I coasted into the money with like two bigs. Oh, what a putz. What a putz. That's right. I told you I don't remember much of it, but I do remember that. And then the week before that, I actually had the nut flush get busted out by a straight flush. So that's why it's all a big blur to me. It's always like a how do I die this week type scenario in the long car home game for me. But I still love it. All right, let's make it happen, guys. This is Ricky Bobby in full effect. Last place this race. Let's go. Cat's Meow says, what about 420 for the West Coast? 120 doesn't mean shit over here. It's true. Just gotta go with it. Someone on Stars, can you do poker commentary? You're pretty good at it. Thanks. Thank you. I appreciate that. I do poker commentary. You will find me here on this channel exclusively as pretty much the main broadcaster, host with the most. I'm here with you. So I host this show every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Closest thing I can get to you with some poker commentary is diving deep in our Torching Cash section, as well as our You Dirty Rat segment. And we have a lot of fun there. But outside of that, stay tuned because we broadcast all the final tables of the Venoms, including the Venom PKO coming up. I know we're gonna have another traditional Venom later this year. We're just here to make it happen. Like I said, the plan is to also be doing some broadcasts later in the year from Vegas out of the WSOP. I assume most, if not all, of the ACR pros are gonna be out there. So we're just gonna go around and have some fun on the channel, guys. It's really what it's about. Pasta TKE started off. No, we do not take 420 breaks in marbles. We take our marbles very seriously, and you're not supposed to smoke while you race anyways. I'm pretty sure that's marbling under the influence and illegal in most of the continental US. Just putting that up. I'm just missing a picture of a shirt. Yes, yes, I need to get, actually I have some really, really fun shirts on the way that I think you guys will dig, including the one I said that had more cowbell in it, so. I love it, I absolutely love it. Pasta TKE still in the lead. Can you hold through the blender? Wow, what a boost. Oh guys, we have the moving finish line though, watch out. This is the moving finish line, it's anybody's game right here. Pasta TKE rolling around. Looks like he will be the first to have a chance, but that finish line might move. You better get out of there right now, Pasta. Oh, that's not gonna work out well for you. Maybe, I don't know, we'll stay in there until it comes back over. Oh my God, well that doesn't, SPB already won, so it's gonna be the next person to finish, so LaFaroux, congratulations. You have SPB to thank for that run. They ran so good, they won twice. But we can't allow it. So LaFaroux it is. LaFaroux, congratulations. And we're also going to pay last place here. Pasta, you got robbed, man. I'm just gonna say it. You got robbed. That was messed up. You were leading the whole time. And you even waited so long in the toilet bowl to catch the finish line, man. This is just messed up. How do you win two races? Everybody's sitting here with like 50 races under their belt and not a single win, and you're like, just win them like, I don't even, you didn't win them back to back. You gave one other person a chance. That was nice of you. And then won the other one, so that's cool. LaFaroux, winner, hit me with a whisper with your ACR username. We will get a 1650 ticket put in your account. Now we're looking for our Ricky Bobby monster. Who's it gonna be? It's gonna be the last person to actually finish. They can't die. If CNK can stick the landing here, could be them. Let's go ahead and confirm real quick. I believe that will be good, though. CNK 2005, that is good. So CNK 2005, you know what to do. Hit me with a whisper with your ACR username, and we will get you all dialed in, folks. As usual, you guys are amazing. I'm your host, Justin Kelly, aka Fat Train. High Five series in full effect right now. Becoming the next moneymaker and your chance to be an ACR pro hanging out with us starts next week. And your grind starts right now. See you guys Wednesday.
Location not here. In shadows we all disappear. Hold on.